Warren Buffet, in the year 1950, was finding out what is not helping him lead his life. He came out with one skill set which he was not very good at, and that was speaking up, the way to talk. He took help of Dale Carnegie in 1950s and said, "Dale, I'm really not knowing how to grow up my communication skills. Can you please help me?" And Dale said, "Well, join my communication class." 1952, he joined Dale's communication class, and then for Warren, there was no looking back. Good morning, everybody, all the Toastmasters. I will take you through my share of ups and downs on the skill set, speaking up. Almost around 1.5 decade ago, when I was about to move out of my engineering days, the entire wave was flowing in the information technology direction. But I'm not somebody who likes coding, so I avoided the coding world. I looked back, what happened to me in the last 4 years? In the last 4 years, during my hostel time, every weekend, there was a long queue in front of my room. And then, what was this queue all about? Any guess? Was I distributing any product which was free, with freebies? No, nothing like that. Was there any product which I was really talking to people? No, nothing like that. But yes, there was something free. And can you guess what? It was a free explanation session on the concepts of the subject. That pulled people. So I was good at that, and people believed that I had mastered on my own subject. Had there been a 360 feedback being taken, maybe my batchmates, my juniors, and of course a few seniors who had back papers and had to appear exam along with us, would have given me a commendable rating. But 9/11 attack had left the entire batch losing. 2001, September 11th, the attack, we went 2002 results, no campus results. Then we had to really struggle. I was moving back home in the train, and then peeping out of the window, I was talking to myself. This jolly fellow with iron will was really trying to find out where is the iron hot so that I could strike right where the iron is hot. I realized I had the power of speaking, explaining people, telling them, teaching them, and explaining them the concepts. Why not I take a chance on this? This opened my doors to the world of education. In no time, this fresher became a faculty. Now again, there was a queue, but not outside the faculty room. It was inside the class. You know why? Not because I was teaching the subject. It's because I started helping them how to prepare for GATE and for CAT. During this whole course, there was a bell which struck in my mind as loud as in the temple. Why not I myself prepare for CAT? And then my aggression had all the lines on, and I took charge of the bulls with the horns. I practiced as if the house was on the fire, and competently came out with 95% CAT score 2005. That led me to a brilliant, beautiful, and vibrant college in Delhi. And I was also a part of the placement team there. Again, the usage of the same skill set, speaking up. I had to go to the corporate HRs, talk to them about the college, speak about the student profile, speak about the research which were done in the college, and convince them to be a part of our placements. Success was again with me. And we placed all 100% of the batchmates in no time. This art, this skill of speaking up helped me twice. One, took me out of the unemployment during the time when the entire world was sinking because of 9/11. And second, it moved me out from the methodological teaching job and paved my way to the charismatic and very clear cutting-edge corporate world. It was giving me laurels, the laurels were getting added, and now everything was going fine till a day when the entire world changed. I was asked to give a presentation on the annual operating plan. An annual operating plan is the budgeting session for an organization. I was well prepared with all the minute details on my presentation. My presentation lasted for around 45 minutes as against the average of around 30 minutes. Though it was long, it was not long for the good. My CEO asked me and yelled at me with his harsh voice, "What are you doing? Do you want me to do your job? If no, then why are you taking us in such details?" I was taken aback. What happened? What's wrong? So well prepared I am. What more could I have put in the detailing session? But no, I realized that I did not prepare for the years of the listening. For the CEO, maybe I would have prepared just a broader picture and not so much in the detail. I was then thinking, the voice was so rough and it was the words were as sharp as the pin, that I was emotionally hurt and tears were rolling out my eyes. I just had two ways with me. Number one, do I succumb to the pressure which was given on me and go inside the cocoon, or I really roar like a lion and fight it back and come to the front? I chose between freedom and fear. I wanted freedom. And hence, I spoke to myself that strength is not a power which comes from winning. Strength is actually the power when you have your hardships, but you know how to face it and how to come out with the flying colors. If you ever have a situation like me, where one of your success parameters leads to your failure, think whether you want to be in the cocoon or you want to roll like a lion. Fellow Toastmasters, thank you.